So there's one more area really to look at here, and that's notifications. For the first section, how you get notifications. And you can see that's by Facebook or email. Push and text messages would only apply if you had phones configured, as I've mentioned. That's not the case. And also then what you get notified about. But let's start by looking at how you get notifications. Now, every notification goes to these little areas here. Notifications will appear in one of these three. That's a friend request notification, messages, and just general notifications if someone's commented or liked something that you do. So they will come through to you anyway every time you're logged in. But if you look away from that, email notifications, if you click on edit, there are two options, and here you could receive all notifications except the ones you unsubscribe from. And this could generate, if you're a very active, or if you have people in your network who are very active, every time they do something that interacts with you, you could get an email about it. And if you've only got the one main email account, that can be quite difficult, because it's going to fill up your inbox with messages that you could have seen anyway. So I strongly recommend changing this setting to only notifications about your account security and privacy, and then click close. So just account related notifications. So in this section, what you get notified about: activity that involves you, which is just an explanation there really. Close friends activity, again there's a setting by default to have messages on both Facebook and email, so I would suggest just limit that as it is there to just on Facebook. Okay, let's just refresh that screen, so it's just on Facebook. When somebody tags you, anybody tags you, certainly I would restrict that to just friends. And then there are notifications for any pages you have set up, any groups you're involved with, application requests. I would suggest, you know, any application requests, you don't really need to get those. Pages and groups, it's up to you how frequently you want to look at those, etc., but leave them as they are for now. So we've gone through general, security, privacy, timeline and tagging, and notifications. And really the most important thing is to just be familiar with where you go to make these changes: account settings and privacy settings. As I've said already, Facebook do change the interface, for example when they introduce the timeline feature, and you will get the notifications, but it's always good practice to check here, probably every couple of months, just to make sure that you've got the settings configured in a way that you're comfortable with.